Hello, my name is Darlene, and today I'm going to be going through my garbage, my empties for you guys. I used up the last bit of a lot of things I kind of just had lying around, which I'm a little ashamed to say that I completely forgot about at least two of these products until I opened a drawer and found them. So let's get started. First thing I used up was the 100% Pure Honey Almond Nourishing Body Cream. Ryan helped me squeeze every last bit out of this. It smells like angel food cake, which is really, really delicious, and it's super moisturizing. 100% Pure is a cruelty-free brand. It is also organic, phthalate-free, and has a lot of really good beneficial ingredients. So unfortunately, it's more of a pricey brand now. It is also vegan, if you were looking into it. I've used more than a dozen 100% Pure products over the years, and some of them I really, really enjoy. A couple are hits or misses. The next thing I used up was the Glossier Milky Jelly Cleanser. I have a second bottle of this halfway finished in my bathroom. This one, when it got close to being empty, I replaced it and put it in my shower, and it just took me a little while to scrape every last bit out. Unfortunately, with these bottles, you can't get everything out with the pump, which kind of defeats the purpose of having a pump. So you have to like take the top off and like scrape it around, or like have it upside down and like smack it against your palm, and you gotta work for it. But it's a good cleanser. I like how I can open my eyes while I'm scrubbing my face with it, because I kind of like to see everything as I'm like going to town. So it's the second step in the two-step cleanse I do after my makeup. Let's just collect the foil packets as we go. So I used a Voluminous Carbon Black Mascara from L'Oreal. This has been going for a good 3 months. There's still product in it, but it's not performing right, and I noticed it's smudging a lot more under my eyes than it usually did, and I'm just not for that. I have a problem where no matter how I set my concealer, a lot of mascaras always transfer after about the 8-hour mark under my eyes, and then I just look exhausted and raccoony. So it's time to go. I should probably apologize for my dog psychotically barking at the neighbors. He hates everyone. Just kind of hates them all indiscriminately, just them existing in the general vicinity of him. And if my voice sounds a little raspy, I just got off work and I have to film 2 or 3 more videos after this, so we gotta get going. Having some tea to relax me. See, the next one I used up was this Shea Moisture Rache Deep Treatment Mask with sea kelp and argan oil. It is purple because I was using my color conditioners in it as well, so I wouldn't have to mix it every time I decided to take a shower, because I'm lazy and doing it once is easier than doing it every time. I used a Bior Blackhead Strip. I don't use these very often. I have like a box of them, and every so often when the feeling, the need gets to me, I use them. I used a soda bubble mask with aqua fruit. That was way harder to say than it probably should be. The brand is Berry Thumb. This was like just like a lower half of your face mask, like in the picture, and it smelled really good. It smelled like grapefruit, which was very pleasant, and it bubbled a lot. I used up the Everyman Jack Aluminum Free Deodorant in Citrus. I like this. It has kind of a, like, I would say, wetter slick to it. Like, your underarms don't feel damp, but you, like, notice when you put it on. I find it works really good as a deodorant. It's a men's deodorant. I get mine at Bed Bath & Beyond. That should not have been that hard to recall. I used up the rest of my Glossier Super Pure Niacinamide and Zinc Serum. This was one of those things I found in a drawer. I opened one of the drawers in my bathroom and found this with like itty bit of product left, as well as the vitamin C one. And I can't even remember when they were there, so that's how much I pay attention. I used up this ClossierBalm.com. These things last forever. I finished the last bit of this up beginning of the month after I found it in a bag. So I had used most of this up last year, and then I put it in a bag and forgot about it. Because apparently that's what I do with things, is put them in places and forget they exist. I used up an aloe soothing mask by Le Fer. Probably saying that horribly wrong. This is a nice, like, moisturizing sheet mask. I enjoyed it. I really do like sheet masks, especially when I'm feeling lazy, because I don't have to wash them off. Because, again, lazy. I used up this little deluxe size sample of the Origins Original Skin Cleansing Makeup Removing Jelly with Willow Herb. I thought it was okay. It worked out fine for a cleansing balm kind of thing. I have a different cleansing balm that I enjoy a lot more that I will eventually repurchase after I'm done with all my foil packets and deluxe samples of things that I don't like as much. I finished up the Andalou Naturals Fruit Stem Cell Science Honey Pumpkin Glycolic Mask. This is old packaging. This is a really good, like, enzyme mask, especially if you aren't into, like, super heavy exfoliant. Like, it works good, you can feel it working, but I never noticed enough of a cell turnover with it. Like, I'd still have dry patches. I'm using something right now that I will be eventually reviewing for you guys when I have been using it for about a month, that I feel works a lot better and is a lot cheaper. And here is the other Glossier one, the Super Glow Vitamin C Magnesium Serum. Like I said, this was also in a drawer. This one I had almost completely finished. I had like two more uses left in it, and I'm a little bit ashamed with myself for forgetting that it existed, because that's not appropriate. I also need to stay in frame. That's also not appropriate. Good job, Dar. So this is the Moisture Shave by Kiss My Face. I've had this in my shower for a long time. I apparently do not shave my legs very much. I don't even remember when I bought this, but it is done now. So it will be going away to recycling. Let's move the bag closer now that we're getting to the bottom of it. This is the SW Basics 3 Ingredients Cream. I would not use this if you have a reaction to shea butter or coconut oil, because this is shea butter, coconut oil, and olive oil. I used this as a cleansing balm after I finished up the Willow Herb Cleansing Jelly from the Origins, and I like it okay. I also use it sometimes on dry patches. Like, it's one of those kind of like multi-use products. It's a oil, basically. And it's all gone. And this was a long time coming. I got this out of a Beauty Heroes box. There we go. It's the Little Fox Jungle Glow Rainforest Honey Enzyme Cleansing Mask. This I also used in my shower. I found that putting it on my face and like showering with it the entire time I was in the shower. Looks like there's a little bit left, but there really isn't. I got in there. It would help hold in the skin's moisture, so if like your skin was super dry and you put this on, it has little granules to exfoliate, and you put it on for moisture and it like doesn't let the shower strip you of your natural like skin barrier, which was really nice. Used up a bottle of contact solution. It's always very interesting. This is the Shea Moisture Manuka Honey and Mefura Oil Intensive Hydration Hand and Body Scrub with African Rock Fig and Balboa Oil. I don't know if I'm saying that right either. It was a really good scrub. Just hear grinding. Doesn't have like a like fancy pretty smell to it, but it was a good scrub. Scrubbed things like scrubs do. We're almost down to the bottom and just have foil packets left. We're almost there. I used up this Real Techniques sponge. Fancy that. It just started not being the right sponge texture, if that makes any sense. Like, I would like moisten it and it just wouldn't like be as soft as it used to be. So I figured it was just done. It's thrown in the towel. I used up this Wella Skin Food. I was trying to like pinch it more and I ended up like ripping the packaging because I'm a savage and apparently can't have nice things. So it's contaminated, but little is left in there. So it is done. This is an Eco Tools. I think this was in their like color corrector set. I have three more of these. I broke one out. I was washing it and it decided to rip itself on the bum. So I think it's decided it's done. Needs to be retired. I used up a lipstick. This is Red Apple Lipsticks Audrey. I really like this lipstick. It's a good everyday pink and it's really moisturizing. The Red Apple lipstick brand are a little bit expensive, but they're gluten-free, so if you have a gluten intolerance and really have a hard time finding lipsticks that work for you that don't cause your like celiac disease or whatever you have to flare up, look into this brand because they have lip liners, lip glosses, lipsticks, and they're mineral based, so might be something that could interest you. Then I also have this itty bitty sample. It's hard to kind of see the packaging, but it's from Modern Minerals. This was a collection, I think. This is their Tea Rose Finishing Glow. And it was just like a kind of a pink finishing powder. Alright, so I have one more makeup product, and then the rest is foil packets, which I've been doing really, really good job of like, and dropping shit. Good job there, Dar. Reach. I got it. Okay, so I have this mask, which was a set. This one as well. This one went with the aloe. So these ones come in the three-step set. So you get the mask to use last, you get a cleanser, and then you get a serum type one. What is the serum? Serum. So you cleanse your face, you use the serum, and then you put on the mask. So I did that with that one. This one was vitamin C, and same deal. Cleanser, serum, mask. I really enjoyed these. I have a couple more that I need to finish, and then I will probably repurchase. I got a lot of my sheet masks in a Pink Soul subscription box, and I might resubscribe to Pink Soul at some point. I really like the amount of like product you get, and I don't really think you need to subscribe for like a long period of time, especially if you're an infrequent mask user. Let's see. I'm trying to collect all of the same ones because I went through several of the same thing. So I have two Feed Your Moisture shampoo samples from, I think it's Yurok. These were good. These are really nice. I didn't find that they stripped too much of the color out of my hair, and I feel like they moisturized well. Then I went through a couple of samples of moisturizers. This was the Confidence in a Cream. I didn't notice any fanciful things with this foil packet. It's a foil sample. I don't expect it to move mountains. Then I went through a sample of the Tatcha Supple Rich Moisture Rich Silk Cream. This I found worked really, really good under makeup, especially more drying foundations, for the little sample that I had. Then I went through a Paracomb ND Firm Surface Recovery Treatment. I don't remember what my thoughts were on this, so it's meh. I went through this Secret Essence Serum. It's like a serum, essence is right. It was good. I didn't dislike it. And then I went through three of each of these. So I got these from a like set at Sephora, where they give you, I don't know how many weeks supply this was supposed to be. I still have two more in my bathroom, but this is the Kores Black Pine Cream and Oil. So these were the cream. The cream smells gross, like weird, gross smell. But the oil smells nice. Like, the oil smells kind of like Sexy Man, like, kind of. So I enjoyed using the oil, but the face cream I completely turned off by. And then the last thing, which I should have said before the foil packets, but I didn't because I'm a winner, was actually one of the things in my Project Pan. So I guess depending on if you don't want spoilers or not, this is a great time for this to be in. It's the 100% Pure Lipstick in Foxglove. It is all the way gone. I don't even think I could use this on my lips again. It's like done. Which I said this would be done by my first update, and my first update hasn't happened yet, so I was right. Congratulate me. So that was everything I used up this month in February. I will hopefully be trying to do this every month if I have enough. If I don't have enough to really show you guys, I'm not gonna waste your time with like two or three things. So it just kind of depends. Maybe I'll have to do this every quarter. We'll see. It's kind of up in the air. Weird question, but do you guys like the closet door open? I know it's mirrored, but does seeing my messy closet bother you more or less than having the mirror there? I know some people don't like reflections. I also think I figured out my lighting finally, so maybe the lighting in my videos will be more accurate to color. We'll see. still a work in progress. I'm also kind of trying to get over the whole weird talking to a camera in my room by myself thing, but we're getting there. Also, let me know, should I collect all my empties for the year, or do you just want beauty and skincare empties? I can keep everything, I got closet space, but I don't know if that's something that you guys would like. So, let me know. Thumbs this video up if you like it. Please feel free to subscribe, and let's discuss what you guys didn't like and what you did like about this so that I can make improvements as I go. Thank you for watching. Bye.